I was just watching the trailer just now. It's so exciting. It's fun. And we're talking about medicine because most shows that are about hospitals is pretty serious. But this is a whole different dynamics to it. What do you think of the show?
Well, I too was a little bit like, can we really do comedy in a hospital? And we can, and we
did. Turns out we can, and it's perfect.
It's called Carol's Second Act, and it's about a woman of a certain age whose husband has left her. Her kids are out of the house, so she decides to go back to school to fulfill her lifelong dream of becoming a doctor.
And gets to hang out with a woman of a certain vibe.
Right.
Plus a few others.
Everyone's just in that hospital trying to make it through the day and try not to kill someone or even worse, get fired.
So what's the overall concept of the show? Is it focusing on your character who's going back and who's a little bit older and trying to survive?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a couple themes here. It's about now instead of women fading into obscurity as they get older, they're kind of moving forward and taking all their wisdom and experience and giving it back to the world and doing something for themselves, you know, because as you know, you're a mom, we're all moms here. It's a 24/7 thing, even if you have another gig outside the home. And it takes a lot out of you, and it's very sacrificial. And here's an opportunity for Carol now to really fulfill her dream. And then it has generational themes, too, right?
Yeah. I think it's just a cool time right now where, I mean, this show is written by women, starring a female icon. And I'm a lady too. And it's just, it's a cool time where in the business landscape, outside of even show business, we're realizing that women not only have a lot to offer, but that being a woman comes with a lot of skills that actually lift projects up. And in the case of Carol, who was a mom and a teacher, now stepping into the role of being a doctor, it's this idea that like, being nurturing is an asset. And then my character is pretty similar to me in that she's gorgeous.
Did she get all the guys?
She gets all the guys to wonder how gay she be. The other cool thing is that my character, I think growing up, I always thought, well, being like South Asian and being, and then realizing I was gay, I didn't really see myself fitting in as an actress. But it's so cool that basically this role is, it's kind of built around, you know, all of the actors in the show are so close to the characters, and my character happens to be gay.
So your character is gay?
Yeah, my character wants to get with her character's daughter.
That's amazing.
Well, what's cool about it, too, is we're at a point in history, I think, where it's not a big deal. Like, it's not a big announcement.
It's not this big slapsticky thing. It's just part of...
No, it's just like that's who we all are, and the focus is... Like, as we said, we're trying to get through the day without killing anybody.
You're hitting all the points. You have women that are writing. You're doing everything right.
That's what I'm saying.
There's change. Change is happening. You're part of the change.
Yes.
What does that mean to you to be in a business like this? And now in 2019, we're saying, okay, this can happen now.
Yeah, like, this must be a great time in television. Yeah. Like I've said that television has always been great for women, whereas on the big screen they often play just a supporting role or their eye candy, with some exceptions. But television has always been very open to women of all kinds of ages and even races to be heading up shows. In both drama and comedy. So, and I've really flourished in television and been able to be a mom too to my kids and not have to travel. So it's been really wonderful. But to see how television has just become this incredible medium with just the quality of it is like a feature film. And so I'm really excited to be kind of riding this next wave of bringing this message about the value of older women to the screen.
Yeah.